this as short as humanly possible so we can get us all back on track. So the one thing that I would comment about commercial real estate is, I think lies, damn lies and statistics. There is so much variation in commercial real estate, particularly when it comes to the life science industry. You see rental rates ranging from a low of $125 up to a high of $10 per square foot per month. So huge variation here in the Bay Area, from county to county, from building to building. Likewise, vacancy numbers, depending on whose numbers you look at, SVN, Cushman & Wakefield, CBRE, Kidder Matthews, JLL, you're actually going to see completely different numbers. So I'm here just to give you a little bit of a flavor, a little bit of an overview. Basically, if you need commercial real estate lab space, you need to bring in an expert who can help you. So that's the big takeaway. And with that, I don't have a clicker, I don't believe, but I am going to see if I can get my presentations here. And while I'm doing that, I just wanted to start off the presentation with a comment. Why can't you just simply use your garage or your office space or your retail space? And so the first slide I'm going to share with you just goes into a little bit of the detail about why not. Because obviously, you've all been aware, we've just come out of the process of coming out of a huge pandemic. Office in particular has been hugely impacted, and we are seeing vacancy levels that have never been seen before, and we're likely to see it get significantly worse. So we were talking earlier about the differences between office space and lab space, and I've got a great slide that goes into more detail on that. One of the key elements is the mechanical, the electrical, and the plumbing aspect. And that's one of the reasons you see such a huge differential between the two sectors. There's two things going on in the Bay Area at the moment because of the lack of lab space. You're actually seeing ground-up development occurring, and you're also seeing conversion of buildings, of office buildings, industrial buildings, R&D buildings, into lab space. But one of the issues there, and if you speak to some of the architects other professionals out there, they will describe trying to convert, let's say, office space into lab space, a bit like trying to convert a car into an aeroplane while it's moving. So that's kind of an interesting quote. But because of the sheer demand, you are seeing a lot of these buildings trying to be converted. You also see landlords jumping on the bandwagon and calling their buildings lab space so that they can command higher rents and actually attract tenants. But when you actually come to tour, you'll find that it actually is not what you require. Ah, fabulous. Left and right, there we are. So I'm a commercial real estate broker, and actually, if you just take a quick step back, I am a commercial real estate broker. I'm actually the national chair for SVN. We are a brokerage company that actually covers all of the verticals, all of the obvious ones. We also do things like hotels and marinas and golf courses. I act as the healthcare chair, which means I cover medical office buildings, I cover senior living, I also cover life science, and I help coordinate all the various brokers all around the US wearing that hat. I'm also, as you can probably tell, originally, or still British. I'm also a US citizen, and I actually am on the board of the British American Business Network that works, is actually the largest transatlantic business that does helps inbound and outbound businesses going back and forth between the UK and the US. And so we work very closely with the British consulate. Right, so again, I'm going to do this at speed to help out Bruce and Zali, but again, just these are some of the issues, and you know, why can't you just simply move into office space? I think the key one on here is the third one along, as I mentioned, mechanical, electrical, and plumbing. But there's a whole host of others, and as we know, as you go into the nuances of what people are looking to achieve, it really does vary. know, do they need negative pressure rooms? Do they need vivariums? Do they need other specialised amenities like clean rooms, ceiling heights, and the like? So life science investment by region, again, some of this was covered by Dr. Kelly and others. And again, there's varying numbers on this depending on what sources you look at and what you mean by the Bay Area. So different numbers here, 13.6 billion coming into the Bay Area according to Cushman & Wakefield, and 21 billion according to JLL. So different numbers. We are being beaten by Austin. So just wanted to point that one out, even though I think obviously we are the second highest on the list. So this is another slide that I thought was particularly interesting. This one is lab space as a percentage of office space in the various different markets. And so as you can see here, we have the San Diego market that is ahead of the curve here with 25%, followed by Raleigh-Durham and suburban Maryland. San Francisco is at 15%. And that's a percentage we're going to be seeing increase very slightly because office is at a standstill at the moment and the life science sector is really going extremely strong and has done over the last 2 years. San Francisco Bay Area is ranked second for the annual percentage gain in office to lab conversions. It's up 266% from the first quarter of last year, 2021. So just look at that number, 266% increase for this time last year. I mean, that's absolutely extraordinary, and obviously office has been zero. Right, again, just going back to the cost of conversion, we spoke earlier about why can't you simply move into your garage or your office space, and I just wanted to point out the sheer cost of both new builds and when you do a conversion or fit out to existing space. So the San Francisco Bay Area, I think we are actually the most expensive on the planet. Probably maybe London could probably give us a run for our money, but I think it's going to be a close race. So you're seeing here, just to build something out, build a lab, that could be over $1,000 just to build out that decent lab space. Right, now I think I mentioned earlier lies, down lies, and statistics. This information is actually from Cushman & Wakefield, and there is vastly, wildly different information coming from both JLL and Peter Matthews and CBRE. So my understanding is that the reason that they're showing the vacancy rate as high as they are, which is over 10%, is because there's something odd going on in, I think it was Santa Clara County that was messing up their numbers. All of the other brokerages are actually showing vacancy rates in county by county. Some of the counties are at zero vacancy for life science biotech space. So San Francisco County, Contra Costa County is at zero. And the other counties are well below 4%, and in many cases below 2%. And that compares with what we're seeing in office space, where we're actually now close to 30% vacancy if you look at downtown San Francisco. So huge, huge differences. So lab space lease rates increased in the Bay Area by 12% last year, while office lease rates basically were static. So changes in average asking lease rates. So I think this again is another one that is, I think, particularly interesting. San Francisco saw a 12% increase in life science asking rents. And again, asking rents different from what may be agreed, and there's all sorts of games that can be played. play with free rent and TI allowances that complicate the picture. But just looking and comparing asking rents, which are relatively easy to better to get hold of, you can see, you know, a 12% increase when we've literally seen office rents be at zero, if not below zero. So that's one of the reasons why you're seeing new construction and conversion going on in this sector, and why you're seeing so much interest from life science developers and from landlords. And Seattle lab space, apparently that fluctuated due to limited vacancy and an influx of new class A open space. So again, sometimes you've really got to get into the numbers to understand why you're seeing some outliers when you're looking at these numbers. So life science planned and under construction. So I think this is one, I think this is particularly difficult to read, unfortunately. So just to draw your attention to a couple of things, and that is the sheer amount of life science and clean tech shell space that is planned. The muddy yellow bar, that is the one that is showing that particular sector. So in particular, you can just see the amount of space that is planned in the Bay Area. And that's what I would draw your attention to for this particular slide. So so what's going on in terms of current companies out there? It's actually worth noting that from when a company gets funded to when they actually need estate space, the timing is usually around 5 months. So you're always seeing a little bit of a lag between funding and then their need to actually grow and lease lab space. And so at the moment, these are the requirements that are being reported by Kidder Matthews. And what I would say here is there has been some chatter that life science valuations are declining and that we are seeing some headwinds potentially coming. So even though at the moment the life science commercial real estate space is extremely strong, we are still basically relying on the companies that were getting funded in 2021 that are out there looking for space now. And what's going to be very, very interesting is if we do see declines in valuations and we do see declines in funding, that could mean that we're actually going to see an impact on the life science commercial real estate space probably later this year and into 2023. So just something to be aware of, and again, that 5 month lag. And I think the other slides, I'm just going to skip over these in the interest of time here. A little bit of an overview. Again, that vacancy number from Cushman & Wakefield, they are the highest, the most conservative of all the numbers. I think the majority of others are coming in, as I mentioned, at 2%, if not 0%, in one which comes to Europe. A couple of representative life science companies out there. And actually, this is something that Dr. Kelly referenced earlier. And I just wanted to echo one of the reasons that the San Francisco Bay Area, you know, in addition to the funding that is here and the networking and the relationships, it is the degrees, it's the educational institutions and the sheer quality of the labor pool here. And that is one of the reasons why the San Francisco Bay Area continues to be one of the top three life science locations. Again, I'm going to just jump over these very quickly. You don't need to go into any detail on any of these. Obviously, the impact of funding, huge impact. So I'm hoping I kept that to at least a little bit under the timing that was originally planned. Again, I just want to echo, you know, lies, down lies and statistics, and the importance of making sure you do get proper professional help if you actually do need to go out there and find space. So again, thank you to Darlene and to you all. Thank you.